Hey guys, today we're going to be talking about maybe you should just hold off a little bit before picking a therapeutic area. Find out what I mean after the intro. Hey guys, ECRG here, back with another episode. Today we're talking about therapeutic areas and which one should you pick? Now, a lot of people may not know what I mean by therapeutic area, but it's basically a area in clinical research. It could be anything from like Alzheimer's studies to oncology to respiratory to ophthalmology, whatever it is, basically an area of medicine that you concentrate in and you end up specializing in clinical research. And they're not all created equal. That's why I wanted to make this video. And this is something I wish I knew before I got into clinical research. Because what tends to happen is you get into clinical research, you get experience in a few therapeutic areas, but as you keep leveling up and getting different jobs and such, they keep recruiting you for your past experience. So if you only have experience in, let's say, Alzheimer's, well, they're going to recruit you for those Alzheimer's positions. And so then 5-10 years go down the line and all of your experience is in Alzheimer's. So this is something that you want to think about carefully because not all of the therapeutic areas are created equally when it comes to this. So, you know, maybe you're just getting into clinical research. You have, you know, maybe got your resume reviewed by us. And if you haven't yet, you can email us at eliteclinicalgroup@gmail.com. We are open for reviewing resumes right now. We've helped out a lot of people do it, and we can for sure improve your chances of getting your foot in the door or getting that dream job in clinical research that you've always wanted. Maybe you have done interview prep with us. You've hit us up at our email address and you've interview prepped with us. You finally got your foot in the door, but you wanna know, you know, is my therapeutic area gonna be good for my long-term success in clinical research? Well, we're gonna talk about the therapeutic areas right now, and they're not all created equal. So the number one therapeutic area, the one where you should get experience in, because that's where you have the most leverage and that is the most in demand typically, is oncology. And the reason for that is oncology trials make the most money for sponsors because people have to take a lot of those drugs typically, and there's no quote unquote cure for cancer, but there are these treatment options, typically a pill of some sort, and they have to take them for the rest of their life after they've been diagnosed with them usually because there is no cure for cancer. So oncology is the most lucrative for the drug companies, and they're constantly putting out more and more oncology trials. So oncology is a great place if you can get your foot in the door there. That is the best indication, and it's typically a lot more complex to deal with also. So if you're able to do oncology, especially as on the clinical operations side, if you're able to do oncology, they will let you do other areas also. Just because of the complexity, they say, okay, you can do oncology, you can probably do, you know, GI or renal study also. So oncology is probably the best one to go into if you can, but it's hard to get there. And also I find that opportunities tend to be presented to you more when you have oncology experience. Someone will make you a CRA faster, or someone will give you a promotion elsewhere faster when you have that experience, just because it's so much in demand. The second best one you can get into is probably something in the CNS field, and that can be anything, Alzheimer's, Parkinson's disease, you name it, anything dealing with the central nervous system, those type of disorders, autism, Alzheimer's, Parkinson's, those are some of the big ones. Even ophthalmology, which people may not think of as CNS, and really it's its own separate thing. But really the eyes are an extension of the brain. So that's why I even said that. But ophthalmology experience is pretty hot right now also. I see a lot of jobs out there for people specifically in ophthalmology. And that's its own separate thing. I've never worked on an ophthalmology study, but I know that they typically want people with experience in ophthalmology to work on those studies. So if you can get that ophthalmology experience, that's really good also. But it's its own separate thing. So number one, oncology. Number two is some sort of CNS. And then the third I'm going to put are going to be either ophthalmology or respiratory. Those are pretty hot right now. Respiratory, like asthma, COPD, that type of stuff. And they want specific experience when it comes to respiratory. They want you to have specific respiratory experience. And you know, those are two where they really require that specific experience, the ophthalmology and respiratory. And you know, they're pretty much in high demand right now. So those are the top three that I would look out for. And really the reason why you want to make sure you get into one of these early in your career is, like I explained earlier, that you're typically going to be in that same unit, that same therapeutic area for a long time in your career. It's going to be a lot easier for you if you've done oncology, for you to get another job in oncology. It's going to be a lot easier for you if you've done, you know, CNS studies, for you to do other CNS studies later down the road when you're looking to level up and move on. So that's why it's best to go in there. And typically the salaries are going to be higher in oncology and the CNS, in the CNS area, because like I said, drug companies tend to make a lot more money. CROs tend to make a lot more money when it comes to those two therapeutic areas. So they're really good to get into because they're really complex. Typically they say, if you can do this one area, you can do the other areas too. So they're just the best for a number of reasons. High demand, higher demand than the other ones for sure. So those are really good ones to get into, and I definitely recommend that. If you've got a few jobs to pick from, let's say you got one in many different therapeutic areas, but you've got an oncology, I would strongly consider picking the oncology one, because a year or 2 years of that is really going to set you up nicely for the rest of your career. And my list is pretty solid there: oncology, CNS, respiratory, ophthalmology. So I would, if you got jobs in each one of those, I would pick literally from that list, from that hierarchy list that I just named. And that's how I would decide if those were the only two deciding, if that was the only deciding factor you had to choose from. Definitely oncology. And I've seen it open up a lot of doors for people when they have that experience. So you want to make sure you think shrewdly about it. Not just the money up front when you're making these decisions on what job to take, not just money, not just lifestyle, et cetera, et cetera. You want to think about the experience and how, you know, a year from now, 2 years from now, getting that experience early can really benefit your career and build that solid foundation for research. That's something I've noticed. I got my start not in oncology or CNS, but in kind of like miscellaneous medicine type of thing. I've had renal experience, GI experience, done a constipation experience, and I found that it kind of handicapped me early on in my career for the ways I mentioned earlier, just because if you don't have oncology experience, they're not going to typically let you work on oncology studies. If you don't have CNS experience, they're not going to let you work on those CNS studies. You've kind of got to meander your way into it. It's not just going to be like, okay, yeah, we're going to reallocate this person over there. And, you know, it's different at every company, but I found at the companies that I've worked for, if you have the experience, you're going to be able to get into those positions faster and more easily if you got that experience. Because don't forget, every single person that works on a study has to be approved by the sponsor. And the sponsor typically wants people that have experience on that given indication before, in that specific therapeutic area before. And that's just going to make things easier and more smoothly when the CRO presents you to the sponsor and say, hey, we want this person to work with us on this study. Are you okay with it? They've got such and such. They got a couple years of experience in this therapeutic area. The sponsor is much more likely to say, okay, let's accept this person and bring them in, rather than someone without any experience in that therapeutic area. So that's something you want to keep in mind also. If you like this video, like it, share, subscribe, hit that bell, please, right next to the subscribe button. A lot of people aren't getting notified every time we release a video, so that just ensures that you're going to get notified whenever we release a video, and that's going to be in your subscription feed. So would really appreciate that. Would really mean a lot if you did that. And if you got any comments, comment down below, guys. Like I mentioned earlier, if you want your resume reviewed, email us eliteclinicalgroup@gmail.com. We will upgrade your resume guaranteed and get you in position to get that dream job you've been looking for. If you'd like some interview prep, you can email us there. We will work with you one-on-one, help you prepare for your next interview. We will go through questions with you, pound you questions, get you ready for that interview. So it's all a part of the process. Resume, interview, coaching, it's all a strategy to get you into that dream job, and we do it all. So email us eliteclinicalgroup@gmail.com if you're interested. All right, guys, take care.